I stated earlier that two of the most important geometric properties of a vector are its magnitude and its direction. These two terms are suggestive of the mathematical concepts they represent. The magnitude of a vector refers to how much movement it quantifies, and the direction of a vector refers to where the director's movement is pointed. Now let's see how to define these concepts more formally. If we think of a vector as an arrow from one point to another, the magnitude of the vector is the length of the arrow, that is, the distance between the two points it connects. To calculate distance, we can use the Pythagorean formula. In two dimensions, we can make a right triangle by taking one leg to be along the x-axis, one leg to be along the y-axis, and the hypotenuse to be the segment between the two points in question. The length of the horizontal leg is the difference between the x-coordinates of the points, and the length of the vertical leg is the difference between the y-coordinates of the points. Then, by the Pythagorean formula, the length of the hypotenuse squared is the sum of the squared lengths of the legs. Now let's interpret this in terms of the vector. The coordinates of the vector give the difference between the coordinates of the points the vector connects, and the length of the vector corresponds to the length of the hypotenuse of the triangle. So the length of the vector squared is the sum of the squares of its coordinates. In other words, the magnitude of v is the square root of its x-coordinate squared plus its y-coordinate squared. Note that we use the double bars around a vector as notation for its magnitude. A generalization of this formula holds true in higher dimensions, too. If v is a vector in n-dimensional space, and we call its coordinates v1, v2, up through vn, then the magnitude of v is the square root of the sum of the squares of its coordinates. Now, using the notion of magnitude, we can define the direction of a vector. Notice that all vectors pointing in the same direction are scaled versions of each other. This vector, v2, is twice the length of this vector, v1. And this vector, v3, is a third of the length of v1. So, for each possible direction of vector, we have a whole class of vectors pointing in that direction. So, to define the direction of a vector, we will choose a canonical or representative element from each class. For simplicity, we'll use the vector of magnitude 1 from each class. We'll call these vectors the unit vectors, since they each have a length of 1 unit each. The process of finding the unit vector pointing in the same direction as a given vector is called normalization. Normalization has two steps. If we want to normalize the vector v, the first step is to find its magnitude. The second step is then to perform a scalar multiplication. We multiply v by the number 1 over the magnitude of v. This scales the vector up or down so that its length becomes 1. So, if we wanted to normalize the vector v equals negative 1, 1, 1, we first find its length. The magnitude of v equals the square root of negative 1 squared plus 1 squared plus 1 squared, which equals the square root of 3. Then, we multiply v by 1 over the square root of 3. The resulting vector u would be negative 1 over the square root of 3, 1 over the square root of 3, 1 over the square root of 3. We can check that u is actually a unit vector by computing its magnitude. In this case, the length of u is the square root of negative 1 over square root of 3 squared plus 1 over square root of 3 squared plus 1 over square root of 3 squared, which equals the square root of 1/3 plus 1/3 plus 1/3, which is the square root of 1, which is also 1. Since u has a magnitude of 1, it is a unit vector. It is the unit vector pointing in the same direction as v, so u is the normalization of v. I should note one last point. If all the coordinates of a vector are 0, we call that vector the 0 vector, denoted as the number 0 with an arrow above it. The 0 vector is a vector indicating no change. Note that the magnitude of the 0 vector is 0. However, what happens if we try to normalize the 0 vector? We would end up dividing by a magnitude of 0, which causes all sorts of problems. So we simply say that the 0 vector has no normalization. Another way to interpret this is that the 0 vector has no direction, just as it doesn't make sense to ask which way a stationary car is moving.